Christophe mal, wenn du mich hörst.
Was?
Ja, ja.
Okay, wie ist das mit dem anderen Mikro? Ist das auch am Start?
Ich würde das lieber testen. Ich muss noch den Screensharing anmachen, eine Sekunde.
Ja, willst du nicht testen, ob das geht, das zweite Mikrofon? Hallo, geht das zweite Mikrofon? Geht das zweite Mikrofon?
Beide Mikros gehen.
Rede mit mir bei der Ansage, aber hier siehst du, wann du live bist.
Das hilft mir, ja. Herzlich willkommen zu Hamburg Stream und Entschuldigung die Verspätung, das Internet schien heute etwas überfordert zu sein. Wir bedanken uns herzlich bei der Alfred-Töpfer-Stiftung für die Ermöglichung der dritten Staffel. Wir bedanken uns bei der Jazz Federation and now allow me to switch to English because we have basically all of East Europe watching tonight and Filip Dinev is a very, very fine musician who actually came here to Hamburg to study at the Dr. Langner's Jazz Master Program and he's an incredible musician and very nice guy and he just finished in December his first album and basically he would like to print it and there I come to the option that you can give donations at hamburg.stream. Please make use of it so that he can print it and other than this please leave your chats and comments for the artists that we will broadcast into the studio so that we have live interaction and I'm looking very much forward to the concert with Filip Dinev.
thankful to Wolf Kesch, who introduced us a little bit earlier. So my name is Filip Dinev. I'm a Macedonian guitar player that's studying guitar here in Hamburg. And I forgot the mic. Okay, let's go again. good evening, everybody. It's so nice that you joined us here on this live stream for the Hamburg stream series. We're super like thankful that we're here. Tonight we have Lucas Kolbe on the double bass and Moritz Hamm on the drums. My name is Filip Dinev. As I said, I come from Macedonia. I'm doing my master's degree here for guitar. Yes, the first song that you've heard was an original of mine. The repertoire consists mainly today of original compositions written by myself and maybe a few songs that we really like to play. The first one was called Minor Bell, and we're continuing with our second one, which is called Budapest. Thank you. you so much. The last piece was called Balkan Blues, because I come from the Balkans. And the next one is quite special to us, because it's a dedication to Ennio Morricone, who actually is one of the most brilliant composers, and especially for film music. And he passed away last year, and I have recorded this arrangement of one of his compositions for the movie Cinema Paradiso. So we're playing a small arrangement of that, and this is in dedication to him, and it means to us a lot. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. This piece was called Reindeer Squid, and was also, it's a new one. We still haven't released this one, but maybe, hopefully, we can record a new album, and it will be definitely on it. We're continuing with one from my first album, actually, which I released in December. It's called Szvetlo. It's with an international jazz trio with a Hungarian double bass player and a French drummer. And it's called Vonatok, which means trains in Hungarian. you, everybody. I think we came to the last piece. This one is also new. It's called It Should Be Easy. I must say, I really like when we write tunes that are in a major key. I think it's very difficult to write a tune in a major key, or something in between at least, and not in a minor key. I think it's very easy to write songs in minor keys. So I'm very happy that this one is kind of major. Thank you, and feel free to ask any questions. And now I'm holding my mic properly, I guess so. And I guess so it works. Not like the first time. I think that was quite legendary. Yes, once again, thank you for all for being here, for listening, for asking maybe questions. And we would really like to, from the sehr herzlich, to thank the guys from the Hamburg stream. We kind of missed the applause, honestly. Hendrik, Julian, Wolf Kieszek and Christophe Schweizer, and everybody that I forgot, of course. Yes. Yes, thank you. This is hopefully the last tune. Thank you.
Hey, thank you for the beautiful concert, guys. Great. It's just, hey, beautiful, beautiful, really. I enjoyed that very, very much.
Thank
very
you
much, very much. And so did the audience. So I didn't know if you see. No, actually, there was something wrong.
Actually,
this explains a lot.
Yes, I think this explains a lot.
I'm sorry. So because you get a lot of support. You thought there was no audience, but first of all, both of our camera people, they're both guitar players. That's why they look like
it's
this.
A setup. It's a setup. I think it's a setup. Okay. That's pretty much understandable. We have a little bit problem with the questions here.
Yeah, but so I brought some. I mean, it seems that they didn't go through. Today was the bad internet day, so even the questions got stuck. But I have some of the questions
Schlecht
for you.
I have quite a lot of those in Germany. I don't know why, but like it's just too much, I guess.
Yeah, somebody was asking, Julia was actually asking, what is your inspiration to write this beautiful music? Do you have any people that you admire?
Julia, this is so hard questions. I think like just the phenomenon of inspiration is pretty interesting, and I don't understand it. I must say like I have no logic. Sometimes you're doing great and like nothing comes out, and sometimes you're not doing great and something comes out, or vice versa. So I really sometimes don't understand this inspiration, like when are we inspired like to write something? But I guess I like the major songs, and when that's always like when you're in good mood, then you write like mostly good major sound music. Yeah, Julia, from everywhere. Franz Boschen,
I think that's a very usable answer. Thank you. And I have a question. So you came all the way from Macedonia. So what is it like the first time being in Hamburg, especially with the Hamburg musicians? I mean, okay, no, you two guys, that's very special. I mean, this is such a beautiful trio sound.
Thank you.
I really enjoy it. So, I mean, I don't want to bias you in this, but I mean, how does it feel coming to Hamburg for the first time? Because, like, from outside.
Felt great, actually. I came with it was a long train trip I took from Budapest. I was studying before that in Budapest. And then first time I arrived in Hamburg was after that. It felt great. I think it's just I think I immediately fell in love with the city. It looked like crazy big and crazy diverse and everything. Yes, and after a while things kind of settled down, and I've met these guys, and we started playing with some other guys from the school. And I must say everybody in the Hochschule is just crazy artistically personal and has something really that everybody's blessed with something really personal and artistic, and I think you kind of don't find that like in a lot of environments, and it's very rare and it's very special, I think.
No, I mean, for us it's very special that you actually arrived here, and we really greatly appreciate that,
so
that you're now here in the city making music for us. And have one thing, I just know you just came back, you were stuck in Macedonia for quite some time, and you just very recently came back, and the story you just started telling me, I think that was quite crazy. I mean, crazy
yes,
times.
It was quite a trip, actually. I think Julia would like would know this as well. So yeah, it was quite a trip. Planes got canceled, everything got canceled. It was raining snow, and I didn't know like in Germany if it rains snow, like all of a sudden there's a problem like in the Deutsche Bahn, and even they don't know like what's going on. And yes, the guy was basically telling me, yeah, just take a hotel, just sleep a couple of days in Cologne, and like somehow you'll get to Hamburg. It was pretty crazy getting here the last time, but now I'm here and everything is ganz gut.
So ganz gut. This, what are your future plans?
Vielleicht ein bisschen Deutsch lernen mehr.
Genau, das ist die Frage. Sprichst nämlich schon perfekt Deutsch. Wir kommen dann mal auf die andere Spur. So, ja, ich sag, da haben wir ja diese Wette laufen, dass Jazzmusiker ganz schnell Deutsch lernen.
Yes, auf jeden Fall. Yes, the plans are hopefully to stay, hopefully to play more music, to spread the music and the love, and I think it's a really special community. And we're just so thankful, especially now in these days, what the Hamburg Stream and Jazz Federation is doing, and the Finna Studios. It's just an amazing thing, even though it's hard. I really, because we are very honest and we speak with a lot of colleagues, and I think like just talks are very. We all appreciate a little bit of talking, like about personal stuff with everybody, and just everybody feels a little bit worried about the situation, but these things kind of really help us get through it, and yeah.
We have to keep the spirit up, and we're much looking forward to much more music coming up soon, so I don't have a doubt about it. But just for now, might be you have a tune, one last tune that you might play as an encore for us?
I think we could play.
This would be nice. Thank you so much. Yes. And see you again very soon, live on stage.
Thank you. And once again, sorry, we have really problems with the questions, and I hope we can somehow answer them privately or by post, or I don't know.
Yeah, just post
would be pigeons. Well, yeah,
pigeons. Letters.